This is a WITC Learning Commons video evaluating websites with the CRAAP test. And the CRAAP test is a tool developed by librarians from Miriam Library at California State University, Chico. The C in CRAAP stands for currency, the timeliness of the information. And here is a list of questions that you can ask to try to determine the currency of the website. R stands for relevance, the importance of the information for your needs. And here are some questions that you can ask as you examine the website to determine the relevance of the website for your needs. The first A stands for authority, the source of the information. The second A stands for accuracy, the reliability, truthfulness, and correctness of the content. And here are some questions. Finally, P stands for purpose, the reason that the information on the website exists. Now, using this criteria, let's evaluate the website of the Mayo Clinic. First, I'll examine the website for currency, and I'm looking for a date of publication, most recent update, or copyright. Sometimes you're going to find that information at the top of the website's home page, but that's not true of this website, so I have to keep looking. On some websites, you'll find a copyright date at the bottom of the page, and that's the case here. I can see that this copyright is kept up to date, so this website is current, and the information on the site should also be current. If you can't find a date in any of those spots, you might try clicking into an internal page of the website and looking around there. So I clicked into the area under the Health Information tab, and I found an article with a date of publication. And I can see that that date is quite recent, so I know that this information is current. Next, I'll examine the website for relevance. Is the information appropriate? And who is the intended audience? You can look at the menu items for clues, and here I see there's a menu where patients can find information on patient care, viewers can find information on health information topics. So it looks like this website gives information for general audiences, as well as a little farther over to the right, there's an area where medical professionals can click into for information for them. So, several different intended audiences for this page. You can also click into the About page and look for clues on who might be interested in this website. And here on the Mayo Clinic's About page, we can see that there's information available on the Mayo Clinic's mission and values, addresses, and phone numbers, facts and statistics, etc., etc. So again, information for a general audience and a wide range of readers. Next, let's examine the site for authority. Again, we'll look in the About Us area of the website. We're looking for an author's name or the name of a publisher, source, or sponsor of that website. And we might also look for the author's credentials, qualifications, and contact information. So we really get a good idea of from whom this information is coming. Now some websites, like the Mayo Clinic, will have a corporate author. And this means that an agency or an organization is responsible for the information on the website. So I'm probably not going to find an individual's name, but we know that the Mayo Clinic is an authoritative medical center and publisher of medical information. So we know that this information comes from a good authoritative source. On the About page, I can also find a link for addresses and phone numbers for the Mayo Clinic facilities. So I know where to contact them. I know where to find them if I have questions about any of the information on this page. The URL of the website address can also tell you something about the author or source of the website. A .org website means it's an organization's website. .com means it's a commercial website. .gov means U.S. government website. And .edu means it's an educational website, probably of a university or college. Next, we'll examine the website for accuracy. Once again, the About Us page is a good place to get information on who and where the website's information comes from, the evidence on which the information is based, whether or not the information is reviewed or refereed, etc. I'm going to click on the research link at the top of the page. And that page is going to give me information on the research faculty of the Mayo Clinic. And here I can see a list of doctors' names and titles, and I can click on any of these doctors' names to see their credentials, their education, and their areas of expertise. I can double-check the accuracy of the information found on this website by comparing it with facts found on other sources. Do they say the same thing? I'm also going to review this website for problems like spelling and grammatical errors and for bias, which can cue me that the content of this website is questionable. Luckily, the Mayo Clinic's website is free of those issues. Finally, I'll examine the website to try to determine its purpose. What seems to be the purpose of this website? Does it only want to sell me products? Or does it inform, teach, entertain, and/or persuade? Well, clearly, the Mayo Clinic's website does not have lots of advertising trying to sell products on it, so it has other purposes. And as I examine it, I find it does want to inform and educate readers about medical topics. The About page tells us that the purpose of this nonprofit, the Mayo Clinic, and its website is to provide medical care, research, and education. And when I examine the entire website, it appears that this is true. When I click into other pages, I can find areas where the website does provide me opportunities to purchase items like books, DVDs, and merchandise. But this publicity does not appear throughout the entire website, so it is not the sole purpose of this website to sell products. Carefully look at the information on a website and ask yourself, is the information fact, opinion, propaganda? Does the point of view appear objective and impartial? Are there political, ideological, cultural, religious, institutional, or personal biases reflected on the website? This website appears to be free of propaganda and bias. Now, practice using the CRAAP test to evaluate another website. For more information on this and other topics, visit us at this web address. This was a WITC Learning Commons production.